Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here, with a video looking at Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, which was released back in 2009. Now you're probably pretty surprised to see your aquatic bird bro doing a Call of Duty video, but this game recently became backwards compatible for the Xbox One, and it is simply nostalgic as fuck for me, so I had to play it. This game reminds me of my early high school years, where I may not have been able to talk to girls, but I sure could quickscope noobs with the intervention sniper rifle. Back then, after I killed people, I would live up to my toxic squeaker reputation and call them a dirty virgin. Well, actually, I still call other gamers virgins all the time, but now that I have been through puberty and my voice is deeper, I upload it to YouTube and try to pass it off as highbrow satire comedy content. Anyway, if you enjoy this video, please comment below pretending to be a triggered Call of Duty fanboy, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. So I booted up Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 on the Xbox One, and rather than having to start from scratch, it actually kept my old account. I immediately remembered that back in 2009, some dodgy nerd from my school had hacked my account and unlocked all of the guns and also modified my statistics to make me look like an absolute animal. As you can imagine, with a kill-death ratio of 318.54, I did not actually need to be able to talk to girls because once they saw that juicy KD, the panties dropped. Naturally, I also picked the cringiest clan tag, emblem, and title I could find to help get myself in the mood. After having a quick wank to my fake but very impressive statistics, I launched straight into the multiplayer matchmaking. I was instantly surprised with just how well an almost 10-year-old game had aged. What makes this even more impressive is that the download size for this game was only 7 GB. Like, what the fuck is even 7 GB anymore? I have videos on my phone of my cats sleeping that take up more space than this game. Anyway, after playing a few matches, I started to get kill streaks. The whole concept of killstreaks is actually pretty hilarious. The game is basically like, oh, I see that you're dominating the other team. Here, have an airstrike so that you can dominate the other team even better than you are dominating them now. It is the equivalent of a guy kicking another guy when he is on the ground. And then someone gives the guy who is doing the kicking a pair of steel cap boots so he can kick the guy on the ground even better. It is a brutal system, but honestly, I love it. These days, if you die three times in a row, most video games will give you spawn protection, vehicle support, a cup of warm chamomile tea, and a bloody get well soon card to mediate the risk of one of their players feeling oppressed. The king of all killstreaks in Modern Warfare 2, though, is the tactical nuke. If you manage to get 25 kills in a row, you literally nuke the game and it just ends. Like, this is probably the biggest fuck you there is in online multiplayer gaming. As if the enemy players had somehow not realized you were killing them over and over again, you literally nuke and end the game and force everyone to go back to the menu screen. I honestly don't know much about life, but I knew I had to get a nuke on my nostalgic Call of Duty journey. I managed to get 7 kills in a row, which earned me the Harrier airstrike, so I called it in and then did the mature thing. I hid in the long grass and waited for my Harrier jet to get a few more kills, and it eventually unlocked my AC-130 gunship. And boy oh boy, this is truly when I remembered how broken this game can be. I entered the AC-130 and rained down shots with the gunship's devastating cannons like it was some kind of spawn trap bukkake party. Seriously, I felt like I was playing the single player campaign or something as I proceeded to commit noob genocide. And then all of a sudden there she was, the tactical nuke. I called it in and terminated the game like it was an unwanted pregnancy. I kept trying to get nukes for a while longer, and I actually did manage to get one more, but then I remembered where the real Sweat Lord 420 Pussy Slayers hang out, and that is the Search and Destroy game mode. For those of you who never experienced Call of Duty, Search and Destroy is similar to Rainbow Six Siege or Counter-Strike, where you have one life per round and have to plant bombs and shit. This game mode is where all the self-proclaimed cool kids hang out. It is a funny game mode because you get to talk to the enemy team between rounds, which allows players to relentlessly abuse each other throughout the game. The really, really, really cool kids were the trick shotters. At the end of each round, the final kill is showcased as the final kill cam. And these douchebags would do their best to spin around a bunch of times and then snipe the final enemy to try and feature on this kill cam to, I guess, try and demonstrate just how small their penises were. In one game, I actually came across some trick shotters. So when I was the last alive on my team, I went and set up for them, which is basically an unspoken agreement where I will not kill them, but instead go and stand out in the open so that they could try and hit their fancy quickscopes on me. Usually when players do this, they are doing it to show support for the trick shotting community. I, however, being the twat that I am, was only pretending to set up so that they thought I was friendly. But then I proceeded to just shoot all four of them for the easiest kills I will ever get. I had such good fun playing this game. It was kind of like catching up with an ex-girlfriend for coffee and then after chatting for a while wondering why I ever even broke up with them. But then the ex-girlfriend pulls out a grenade launcher and fires the noob tube at me 50 times in a row and I suddenly remember exactly why I broke up with them. The grenade launchers in this game are messed up. Not only can you equip a perk that makes the explosions bigger, you can also equip another perk that gives you infinite ammo for the grenade launchers. Hearing the sound of those bad boys going off gave me some kind of gaming PTSD. That being said, coming back to Modern Warfare 2 was actually refreshing. It was a time when soldiers looked like soldiers. A time when players who were good at the game were rewarded, not punished, and therefore this encouraged gamers to get better at the damn game. A time when social justice warriors and political messages didn't plague video games. And a time when my balls hadn't dropped yet, and the only two things I had to worry about were my win percentage and whether or not my parents would find the six-pack of beers and the nudie mag I kept hidden under my bed. Anyway, that's it from me, you legends. Thanks for watching, and thank you to my generous, hydrated patrons. Otherwise, until next time, and as always, stay classy.